Say hello to,
What's
say hello,
that?
Robert.
Hi. Is that a temperature thingy?
No, it's not. It's a GoPro. It's a camera.
It's a camera?
Yeah.
Are you going to stare at me like that?
Well, no, you're going to say, what's up, everybody? Sorry. That can be very complicated because I just had to go and drill sergeant my leg. Just go check your DMs!
What a go-to.
Is there a message? Is there a message you want to say?
How can I help?
Is there a message you want to say?
A message?
Yeah. COVID related or anything? COVID related or anything? Okay, can you give a message COVID related or whatever you want to give a message about?
No.
All right. So without further ado, let's go ahead and let's talk about this whole entire battle with neighbors. You know, there's always battles with things that happen throughout time. And, you know, people, they get in a fight, arguments, and sometimes it's with complete strangers on social media. And as you guys know, that the social media can be very, very toxic and very, you know, not a good place to go. There has been people who have lost friendships over social media because they say the things that they say, regardless of how old they are. And today, we're going to be talking about grown 30-year-old, 40-year-old men and women, mostly women, who are going to clash back with someone who's older than them. And that is the kid. What happened was, there was this one day when the kid was driving, we were coming back from the beach, and what happened was, as we were driving, there was a guy who told us to slow down. What happened was, when he told us to slow down, we all of us heard it, and we went back and parked, and the kid got out, walked on over to go confront the man, because the man walked up the street to go talk to a neighbor across to us on the side. So we go over and talk to them on the side, and you know, she's pissed. The kid's pissed. She was so mad, and then she wanted to go and just yell at this guy. And that is what she did. Right, so what I'm saying? So that's what happened was, got out, went up and confronted him and then said, "Excuse me, sir, but did you tell me to slow down?" And that's when they started getting into these fights. So that's when they started going back and forth. So I started recording, and I had the original video. I deleted it, and I made a video. I did the original audio and like paused. There really wasn't much to say. And anyway, she was like saying, 20 miles an hour. 20 miles an hour. I wasn't speeding. I'm like, I don't know if you guys have gone crazy or something. And then the other woman, the neighbor, would say, "Well, there's a lot of little kids. But you were speeding." I'm not speeding. I'm not speeding. I don't speed through the neighborhood. I'm very aware of the things that I'm doing. So yeah, so what happened was is that the neighbor had said, if you are okay, if you're not speaking, then just go home, please. And then she said something, and then said, "Well, you tagged me in my driveway." So, but yeah, I was mad too, because I'm like, really? You couldn't act like a normal human being? I mean, the kin, both parties were just being a little bit childish. And yeah, so then you might think that that would be the end of it. Well, a week or a month prior, before that happened, it was like the day before 4th of July, Ofcam was in the car and they were speeding in the neighborhood, and the Canada cop's wife had said, "Slow down." So I went to go walk down the stairs and I look outside and he pulls up and I'm like, "Were you speeding?" And he's like, "Maybe, yeah, maybe I was going a little fast." Well, then a little after that, there's a knock at the door. And there's a knock at the door, so I'm like, "Hey, the door's right there." So I record that, and nothing really was shown then. As soon as came out, she said, "We would just like to ask you to slow down when you're driving, because if you hit a kid, you go to jail." Anyway, so what happened was, right after that happened, there's a couple other neighbors who were saying stuff to him, and I didn't catch that, but yeah, so then that was brought up later, because you can't be speaking neighborhood, but people just zero this in with all negative comments.
Thank you.
much like that happened with the speeding. There was a Facebook post made by a neighbor who was saying, please slow. I've been watching so many drivers speed, and some even squeal their tires and stuff like that. And you know, neighbors here, well, neighbors in Virginia Beach, I should say, there's no kids here in the Virgin Islands, but there are kids in Virginia Beach that would always go out and be outside when they would be doing things. And there was a comment made saying about the swing tires. So then there was someone who said, I agree. And then this Carlitos Rivia said, I'm with you, Joe. Last time I told someone to slow down, they got all upset saying they weren't going more than 20 miles an hour. The speed limit is the speed limit. There is no such thing as 5 over. And then off-cam responded to that, getting himself involved, saying, so you go exactly 55 on the highway and apparently failed math, as well as more things, I'm sure. Smiley face. 20 minus 15 is 5, but less than 20 does not equal 5. Perhaps you misunderstood what you heard. Do not misconstrue. You are making nothing out of nothing. And he said, then he responded to that saying, I do speed on the highway if you have to ask. Also, before sitting behind a keyboard or a cell phone telling me that I have failed other things and try to get to know me personally. Look, Joe, you started this post and lives right next door to me. I don't know you. You don't know me. The issue is that there are too many people speeding and I'm not the only one that is tired, especially when I have a five-year-old who happens to play in the street. Next time, please use your words wildly. If you want to get to know me and my family, you're more welcome to come over and get to know how hard me and my wife work to live in a good neighborhood and a self is not for sale. And then the Canada cops wave and respond to that saying, there are little kids playing on the interstate. Doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out why speeding in through a neighborhood, through a residential neighborhood, is a bad idea. And, yeah. So, what happened was, the original comment about, like, the whole math thing, I think that's kind of a little bit misconstrued as well. Because, yeah, going 5 over, some people see that as speeding, although, you know, you're not going exactly the speed limit. I mean, there's all kinds of drivers out there that go the speed limit. And then others would go 5 over the speed limit. And, you know, that's what people usually do when they're driving on the road and they're not going that speed, but like let's say they're on the highway in the fast lane, people go over the original speed limit. That's what they do. Now if they're doing 10 over 15 and 25, then that would be considered speeding and they could get pulled over for it and could get cited for speeding. Now I don't know if that's how fast that off-cam was going, but yeah, so if you're in a residential neighborhood, do not speed. But another thing is, if you're going to confront somebody, know what you're going to do, because in this world, you don't know what you want them to do. Anyway, moving on. Then, the Robert boy is Angus Biatch, and you know why I call her Biatch? In a very respectful way possible, is she made a comment to me, tagging me in a comment, and I wasn't happy about that. I read it, and I wanted to say something, but, you know, I didn't say anything. Anyway, so it said that the speed limit is 15 miles an hour, plain and simple. There's no reason to go on a community page / post and be calling your neighbors. We're all stuck with each other. It's one simple thing to do. We can follow the speed limit. By doing that, we keep each other and all and the children safe. There are plenty of people who walk around. walk our dogs and play on the street. Let's just be courteous and do undo what others would want to done to us. Last thing I want to see is someone to go to a pediatric pedestrian person, a motor vehicle in my neighborhood. Alright. Well, I'm gonna make a negative one for this. Alright. Here's where the kid got involved, and here's where all this started. The kid said roadways are for motorized vehicles and pedestrians to cross, not for children to play on. You choose to allow your child to play in the street, you suffer the consequences. The responsibility is yours. Stop trying to make the rest of the world adhere to your lack of parenting or ability to provide a safe play area for your child. I'm not advocating speaking by any means, but yelling at someone for something that could have been avoided for both parties seems unfair in my opinion. We all have backyards. I'm tired of hypocrisy. Alright. So, with that post that was made, that comment, it is kind of a little bit, what's the word, dark, and not exactly a way to word it, and that's why it was misconcepted. And that's why it came off sounding like this person did not want kids out in the street and wanted kids to get run over and wanted, but didn't want to advocate speeding. Right? So, first of all, the kid had said that roadways, the street in that neighborhood is not exactly a roadway, it's a street or neighborhood. And, you know, with the given state that is, you know, driveways being small, stuff being small, the kids kind of have to play out in the street. And when they're out in the street, their parents are not watching them or even teaching them how to move out of the way for the car. And as it's coming down the street, it's, you know, it's, they're gonna have to, you know, beep the horn, flash the headlights, or get those, or say something, get those kids out of the way. That's what I've had to do, that's what other drivers had to do, because they're too young to pay attention, right? Well, then here is what they said, you suffer the consequences, meaning that if your child gets hit, if a kid gets hit, basically what's saying is that, you know, you let them play out in the street, they could get hit by a car. And even 50 mile an hour zones, you know, like with the Cannon Cops police car, I saw my Cannon Cop video. You know, you guys could hardly ever see what was going on. Anyway, so like what I said you know, stop making the world like to your parenting. That was kind of a little bit, you know, coming off as, but anyway, so then what's going down is that not beginning with beatings. Now the hypocrisy was, you know, with the hypocrisy and everything. Anyway, with this comment, it's not exactly valid, and it could have been worded differently, so there wasn't this confusion, this misconception, all these haters. You know what I mean? And all that comment caused problems for me, problems for off-cam, and problems for the kin themselves. Because there were comments that you guys are gonna hear that someone's made about me, and all these things about me riding my bike. Because I do ride my bike often in the neighborhood, like two times, three times a day back then. And so I don't ride. And so, you know, I always ride my bike a lot. And what happened was, is when that happened, people brought that up. Said that, so then Robin Boyer Angus Biatch had said, you have no right to attack someone's parenting who you do not know me or anyone else in the neighborhood. The story is my children are not just playing out the street. My youngest is now 10-1 and the oldest is never outside without me. However, she's 4. I live in a very front neighborhood, and for that reason I feel safe on my children to be in our front yard. We do walk our dogs and go out for bike rides or run, walk. We live in a rather small community without sidewalks, whether it is weird that or not. We always meet kids out in the street, young ones, parents, older ones without. We should all be able to run, walk dogs, biking, and without worrying someone speeding and hitting us or our children. And yes, we all have backyards, but some are barely a yard. I do stand by my comment earlier that the speed limit's being plain and simple. Slow down. Also, belittling someone of their education or post is uncalled for. My stance might change on even that. So then what happened was is that Kara Wilcox had said, "So our children should be riding their bikes or playing. Lovely neighborhood we moved into. I am always out with my children, and honestly, I was hoping children could move to a neighborhood where I guess we could be looking out for. Guess what was delusional." Alright, so then the canine cop's wife had gotten involved and said, "Doesn't your son ride his bike around the neighborhood all the time? How would you feel if one of these speeders hit him? We've actually prevented your son from being hit before, so instead of calling out people for their parenting, maybe you should thank us for who are in the street saving your son's life." Alright, so I just want to back that up. The canine cop's wife did not, and her husband did not save me. The person that saved me was moi. I have not had a situation on that bike that I've not had under control. Alright? And, you know, they never have said anything about anything about me about them saving my life. The only time I recall about them saving my life was when there was a car that I wanted to let pass and I was waving, and her husband just stopped in his tracks staring me down. And what happened was is when that happened, he yelled that car to slow down when they were not even speeding. I was letting them go by. They think that they were flying down the road. They were not flying down the road. The thing is, I was waving my hand so they could go by. And that cop thought that there was something going on, because that car was way back there, needed to get out, so I let him go so he could pass around me. Plain and simple. And here's the canine cop wife starting to get nippy. Anyway, so I said, "Oh wait, you're mad because I personally berated your boyfriend for driving like a bat out of hell down our street. I get it now." Possibly. "Oh, was that you? Oh, was that you? LOL. My fiance did acknowledge he was driving too fast. Unlike most people, he admits he's not perfect. Nothing personal was targeted towards anyone." So, and then here's where the biatch, I'm trying to think of a word that's insulting without me actually saying it. Karen. Alright, so Karen McAuliffe Gina Ralliston. We're going to call her Karen. Anyway, so what happened was is she had said, "So are we going to discuss you're driving while intoxicated?" And it got up faces. And then she replied saying that, "That's not an accusation you want to make." And then, "I'm not stupid, don't you dare threaten me. Do not accuse me of anything unlawful. That's a defamation of character. You're the one who is going to be chastity, the parents of this neighborhood, when you're pretty much the only one with the conversation telling me that your son is likes to ride his bike a lot, and he doesn't bother around. I get it. So you ever been so watching about your son to that very moment, but it's sad to not realize that that you know you'll do the same for the other children. You've been pretty clear with your actions now, or two. All right, listen. I can handle myself, and the kid does not supervise me at all. Doesn't make like that. It's unnecessary. I can handle myself. If there is a problem that happens, then I would report it to the kid, or otherwise I'd take care of it myself. But you know, the thing is, the kid does things in a different way. Like one time, a bully harassed me. She made a post on the comment page. And the other time I had a severity bully harass me, throwing water on me and etc. She actually had, well actually, it was her initial thought to make a police report. I wouldn't handle things like that. You know what I mean? And there are all kind of things that the kid does who doesn't know how to handle it directly. She always has to do it through the police, through Facebook. It's what she does. She doesn't do it directly, not most of the time. And I've responded to Gina McAuliffe's Ralston's post. GMR, you need to remember you don't have the right to tell me what I can and cannot do. You go to a public forum and out of nowhere accuse me of doing something lawful and unfounded and want to get on your high horse and say something about me, hypocrisy. Mind your own business, apparent to me that the type of person you are. Then keep your drunk ass out of my driveway. And then said, I don't have the right, I'm sorry, but didn't you begin this with saying what parents could not do? And then she had responded saying, you need to remember that yourself, not the cop's wife said, you need to remember how close our houses are. Your fences, it isn't soundproof. I wasn't drunk. It was on HOA property. It's in the middle of the street. Yup, when it comes down to the safety of the kids, I'm going to be all up in it with observation. I'm legally deaf, people. If it's anyone's business, I'm a loud talker and is my family, so I can hear them. Any questions about anything, you know where I live. You don't need to be, you need to read again. Don't be a hater. Good night. So basically, yeah, and I think that it was, and I think that bringing up issues is not the best way. I'm just like, really? This, everything that happened there is so uncalled for. It's all uncalled for. Anyway, so then Carol Wilcox said, let's get back to everyone slowing down. Tell me how you face the consequences. Even my child is out playing, even with me outside, tells me there's an attempt. It's not hard to slow down, let's take care of each other. And then Round Boy, I guess Biatch had said, exactly. Dude. So yeah. Let's go on to what else was upset. So then Kelly Humphrey had said, wait, this chick is saying no one can tell her what to do. Not fam. You can't run over children. Sorry. Hashtag selfish. Plus, you say that you're deaf and people should accommodate your loud speaking in the way you choose to live, but you can't show the same respect for your neighbors. Selfish. And then Chelsea Charmer had said, I was waiting on my bus alone not long ago, and there was children coming off, and bus presented to the parents, and the car was speeding. When he stopped, they were all over screaming and jumping at his car. He stopped literally inches from hitting a child. According to good logic, a mother shouldn't have to deal with losing her son because children are meant to be on the asshole. You should be disgusted with yourself to say such an ignorant thing. Parents are bad parents who land their children and leave the front yard. You aren't a terrible person. And a felon for hitting a child and killing a child. How should I put this? I just think that was way too ridiculous. Let's move on. So Kelly Humphrey had basically repeated the same comment that happened when the kid had made a comment about the guy behind this kid who harassed me. And the kid had said, "Get a grip, people, twist any way you want, the street's not playground for just a play on, period. Call me name, make up all heard, say whatever. I've never let my child play in the street. My child is not a child, he's old enough to decipher when there's danger, unlike a 5-year-old. He rides his bike, follows rules, yes. Not perfect. I pray he's safe, but it's a chance that he's gonna do run a cycling. No one's advocating the run of the children." Seriously? Okay, but you post about your kids' safety and respect, sir, on your ways. So which way, sir, which is it? And then here's where the Canon cops' wife pissed me off. She said, "Your child ran over my child while riding his bike years ago. Where were you to supervise him? Just stop." That did actually happen, though. I did actually hit her kid, and yeah, it was ridiculous. Anyway, so then Charles Jarber had said, "That's precisely what you did, saying we suffer the consequence of having our children playing in the streets," which is referring to. "And if your son got rocks thrown at him," Kelly Humphrey said that, "and continue cycling after, then your backyard, then your injuries are your fault by logic, correct?" He was 18, really? "Do you allow them to play on train tracks too?" Said, "The only thing I can gain from this is anything you said is jaded. Now you don't have a small child, you have no regard to your children. He was 18 and you felt like you need to get on Facebook and ask people to be nice to him. But the dad getting on Facebook saying, 'Hey, if you can have another bike, child,' and you know, it's bad parenting. Get over yourself, you're being a twat and shitty neighbor." This post started and ended with the message of "Don't run over kids on bikes, and you had to be an asshole. I hope your son is what you're proud for, you stand for." The kid was not being an asshole, and the word asshole goes for men. The kid is a woman, so that does not really make sense, unless they're thinking of the kid being a trans or something. But no, the kid's not a trans. All right, if they, you know, and so the word a-hole only goes for men, not women. Just throwing it out there if you get your vocabulary messed up, if you get all cussy. Anyway, so what happened was that it said exactly, and said, "I never asked him to be nice to him, I just acted the right there and stop." And so, he didn't get told for stopping himself. But it's true though, because if I had to go, and, I mean, I wouldn't assault anybody, but if there was kids throwing rocks at me, I would tell them to stop, or I would contact the police. That's what I would do. You know, I'm not gonna go and deck a kid in the face because they're throwing rocks at me. You know, I'm not gonna do that. I would just call the police. Anyway, so then, just goes to show how low this neighborhood is about. Having an opinion of differences from the masses, you can't handle it, gotta name call, dig up the past, take their handicaps, and use them against them, peace, I'm out. And then said, "You asked for rocks to not be thrown, and the dad asked you not to kill his child with the car. How do you not say the same blade? The only handicap is that you are a selfish, rude, and can't see what the right thing is, but you can hide behind your fake news story and your deaf shit. Good luck with that." Fake news story. That did not actually happen. We actually did find a noose in our dog crate. We thought that there was someone threatening us and threatening that we have a noose. So we contacted the police, but we didn't contact the police, but we just let go. We don't know who did it. It's gone. It's in the past now. Let's move on. Anyway, it said, "This is not different in my opinion. You blatantly said, child on the asphalt, child on the asphalt will suffer the consequences, which we have all assumed as being hit by a vehicle. As you and who will be nice and kind to your son to ride his bike unsupervised." I'm literally a freaking adult. So, Yeah. I'm literally an adult. I can do whatever the heck I want. That's what I do. People want to act like that. Anyway, and I don't need to, and I don't need to know boobs to tell me. Anyway, but yeah, so like I was saying, is in then condemn parents for having their children anywhere than your backyard, even while supervised, and you may want people to dismount from their high horse and realize you live in a neighborhood where the majority of people look out for lunch, please. I think Kelly Humphrey had said, you implied that this isn't a lovely neighborhood because of Facebook's spat that you are justified by harming children on the roadway. No, honey, this isn't lovely. It's because of injured children on the side of the road, not from Facebook's spat. Twisted, I've stated this over and over. I'm not advocating this by any means here or anywhere. The last thing I want to see is a child and animal getting injured by a vehicle. That's not what my point was making. My point was, I got lost and everyone would need to defend their parenting. And everyone needs a personality to attack me. So be it. I can take it. Two wrongs never make a right. Good night. And they commented, saying, you are a true gem. Then what's your point then? I don't see anyone justifying you or anyone, their parenting. They are just simply pointing out that you can't run over kids in the street. B, the only thing is that any logic you thread is that is good night and you keep posting. You live with people, I suggest you be very careful with the car because after these statements, you do so much of a clip a kid on the mic, you are going to end up in a courtroom defending your lame ass argument. And the kid responded, I'm never a victim, I am it. Stay tuned for tomorrow's date when I talk about. And then let's go and talk about where it came from there. So after that incident, and I know it's kind of a little bit. So the kid had talked to our neighbor, and the neighbor's like, yeah, that's lots of BS. And because, you know, one of our neighbors was riding, was in his truck, and he almost hit, and like there was a kid in front of him, and the neighbor starts yelling at him and stuff for no reason. And he was very upset. And then what happened was, is I got a comment, is I made a comment saying, hey guys, I care about the people of this neighborhood, blah, 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 blah. And I basically explained them everything of what I do and what my point is, because, you know, there's people saying all these things about me on social media, and I'm not gonna sit back and let people say crap about me. So that's why I got involved and I said what I had to say. I probably should have got involved in the first place. Anyway, so there was someone that would respond back saying, trust and understand that no one's attacking you or blaming you for what you did. And then the can of God's wife got involved saying, Tristan, this really is bothering me. You know, I don't want to be that horse. You said you couldn't get hit, you, a kid could get hit in a wide open street when it was your mother's job to teach you before she lets you in the buses. And I have to say, see, so what happened was, is when I had said that, and it said that, you know, that no one's blaming for what you did, I hope you know that. So I just leave my comment, I'm like, you know what, I'm done. Yeah, so let's go move on to the thread. I heard from one more than the neighbors saying that they're tired of children constantly in the road and parents are not watching them. Guess some people are too afraid to speak up. Good night. If you don't want kids to be in the neighborhood, maybe you should consider living somewhere else. It's unfortunate now your child is an adult and that so the rules don't apply to you. Would you extend the common courtesy to move out of the way for your son who stopped for your son? And stop for your son. We're the ones who drive under the speed limit, so we watch other children because I know it takes some to keep them safe and adults. But yeah, you know, that's expected. Move out of my way. Stop. That's what expected. Okay, just because the kid thinks a different POV than the way I have this POV, okay, is that it is, you know, just because that you guys move out of the way for the common courtesy for me, doesn't mean that you gotta just rehash that and then come at me saying I'm an idiot driver. You know, I don't drive the kin. The kin drives himself. I just ride around. I have that kind of respect that I've earned. And that people are trying to wheel and wagon in the kin's face like a penis and, you know, say, oh, we're so good now. We can run away from your son. Why can't you say they for us? Well, you know what? Anyway, but yeah, so like what I said is if you don't want kids playing, whether you're tired of the kids in the road, there's an HOA, and they're not gonna, and they're gonna penalize people for speeding and speeding. Your son is now on this thread. You've literally been telling people to be more careful and more conscious on the road. Maybe you shouldn't actually go to bed like you've actually been threatening. And so then, here's where the last comment came in. The Kelly Humphrey biatch. With a ch-ch-ch. Anyway, here's where there was a comment directed towards me. And I'm like, anyway, so this is either Robin Boyer Angus Biatch said, I hope you, and tagged my name, saying, I hope you know that you, along with everyone else in the neighborhood, deserves to enjoy the outdoors by whatever means you enjoy. You do so by running by others, by walking, running around their books. It's important that we all deserve the right to be safe and activities while we enjoy and cars and trucks to slow down. Neighbors, we should just want everybody to be safe and happy. And unhealthy and safe. Did I say unhealthy? I mean healthy and safe. To those who disagree, life is so short, and why do we do have a right to keep to try to be decent? Kids are going to be kids, also they should be important, especially when they're down and back living in the apartment of a backyard. Especially right now with no school, as others have with family neighborhood. Most of us are out with our kids and out, but parenting is always present. We all try to watch our children. It's what we do. If you have a problem with a child or someone's parenting skills, be an adult and address it with the parent face to face. Problems don't be solved by gossiping. Alright, so let's talk about that. That's where I got pissed off. Because I'm like, who the heck are you telling me I need to be an adult? And who the heck do you think I need to be the one to accommodate for that? Take that to the kid. I didn't say I'm going to run over kids, speed the neighborhood, break the rules of the road. No. I'm not going to break the rules of the road. Yes, I make mistakes here and there, but I don't break the rules of the road. Not often. Sometimes I make mistakes, but, you know, I'm not a perfect driver or cyclist. But yeah, you know, if you guys got something to say like that, you know, hey, you know, how about you being the adult and, you know, not trying to clash with a teenager and who literally did nothing wrong, and why don't you just keep your butt quiet and not get your butt involved and cause problems in the neighborhood on the Facebook post? I just think that it just gave everybody the excuse to talk shit about me, the kin, and off-cam. That's what they think that was there for. They think that it was appropriate to talk about me, off-cam, and the kin. That's what they thought. They thought it was appropriate to talk shit about us. And I'm like, you know what? Fine, talk shit about us. I hope you know I have this all recorded, so I'm going to save it for future evidence. Yeah, you know, I don't give a crap. And you know what? I would have brought him doing it face-to-face. I got run with someone, I would go run them myself. You think I'm a gossiper? Oh no. How about you tell the other damn neighbors? Yeah, so that really steamed me up, and you know, I'm like, what the heck is wrong with you? Anyway, guys, but yeah, you know, don't get on a public Facebook page and complain about everything that's been going on with your neighbors, because anyone can see it, and that's what causes the problem. Because I just think that what these neighbors are doing are foolish, childish, and ridiculous. I think they could have all de-escalated the situation by just keeping their mouth shut, you know. And with all further ado, I just think that they were just ridiculous. So yeah, so you know, just don't go on a public Facebook page and talk crap about other people and the issues that you're having with your neighbors or speeding or anything like that. Or even berating somebody, berating somebody about being deaf. Yeah, they are legally deaf, but that's why we gotta talk loud at times. That happens here and there. And all these things. And with Kelly Humphrey, with other people as well, I'm just like, oh my God, are you serious right now? You're gonna act like that? And yeah, it's really ridiculous. And it's very sad on what this world has gone to, because everybody nowadays are very, very mean, and people nowadays are very, very mean to each other, very rude, and there's a lot of fighting that happens, a lot of arguments and stuff that happen to complete strangers, and it happens a lot. And so it's very important that everybody knows who they're messing with, because things can get ugly real fast. And that's why I think that all of this could have all been avoided had the kin kept their mouths shut, had off-cam kept their mouths shut, and they let the guy who made a post about the kin and let it go. Instead, they escalate to an argument. And I'm gonna get my mouth shut too, but I'm not gonna sit here and let people bash the kin and off-cam. No, it's not gonna happen. And I just think it was all uncalled for. The whole thing was all uncalled for. 72 comments is just ridiculous. So anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. And remember, slow down in neighborhoods. Don't get on public forums and bash your neighbors. And have fun. Thank you guys for liking, yes, comment, guys, subscribe. And I'll see you.